Well, here we are at Warren Street Station, because we're going to look at Fitzrovia, which is the area bounded by Euston Road, which is the main road there, and Tottenham Court Road, and down at the end of that, Oxford Street. I don't know what's over this way. This is Fitzrovia over here. So I don't know what the western boundary is, but probably won't reach it. Global Network for the Materials Cycle. I don't know what that's about. It's early-ish in the morning. On Bank Holiday Friday, so not busy. Whitfield Street. Euston Tower. Up there. A flute shop. Grafton Mews. Ooh. Some Lady Di stuff. I think it's a cafe. Another hair shop, another cafe. So there's the Euston Road, Fitzroy Street. And that is the post office tower. Well, what it used to be called. I think it's Telecom Tower now. They keep changing the names of things. Good morning, London, it's saying. It doesn't have as many microwave dishes on it as it used to have. It used to have big Clystrons or something, but they're not there now. So I guess they're radiating at a higher wavelength or something now. Anyway, this is Fitzroy Square. Should we wander around? The Fitzroys owned this area way back in the day. So these places were built, I suppose, around about the 1790s. Private gardens for the residents is common in London. We have the Mozambique High Commission up ahead. And the Republic of Liberia there. And who lived in this house? Robert Gascoigne Cecil, 3rd Marquess of Salisbury, Prime Minister once upon a time. Quite a nice little garden for them. Virginia Woolf used to live in number 29. And in fact, George Bernard Shaw lived there before her. The sort of, I don't know, bohemian scene was based around here. Back in Victorian times, I suppose. Or a bit later than that, really. Early 20th century. Adam, I presume, is the architect of this square, 1728-1792, and I think George Bernard Shaw lived down here as well, maybe at number 39, I'm not sure. There's no plaque here, but I think he lived around this side of the square later on. Get the impression he must have had a bit of money, as most of them did. To be an artist, you're either poor or rich, I think. So back on Fitzroy Street, and we have a chap. Francisco de Miranda, precursor of Latin American independence, born in Venezuela, died a prisoner in Spain because they didn't appreciate his revolutionary activity. Chapman Court Road down there. Students in there or something. Look like visitors actually. Because this is a big area for University College London. There's lots of stuff of theirs around here. Musical notes up there. I don't know what the building is. Something musical, presumably. Can I see? I guess not. It doesn't seem to have a sign, does it? Oh, there we go. Sainsbury Welcome Centre for Neural Circuits and Behaviour. It brings together world-leading scientists to investigate how brain circuits process information and generate perceptions and form memories and guide behaviour. When you thought it was just a supermarket, eh, Sainsbury? I suppose it's the same person or family at least. We're now on Charlotte Street, because Fitzroy Street kind of changes into Charlotte Street. It's all part of the University of London redevelopment, apparently. Just see the post office tower at the top there. As I've said before, there's loads of money around, it's just not in my pocket. We have Chitty Street over there. I don't know what it's like to live on. Like many people live there. Who wants to live on Chitty Street? Brexit sketches, who? What Brexit? prices. Shall we have a quick look? $3,250 a month, $1,842 a month, $7,366 a month. Tottenham Street, $1,647 per month. That's cheap. here we are, 2 million leaseholds. You don't even get to own it. Right. Hogarth Studios. Possibly something to do with the famous chap. Just wander over here. Scala Street. I'm coming down here because there is something to see. If I can find it. I'm also trying to stop my keys from rattling. Bit difficult, let me have a go. Right. Right, anyway. Here we have Pollock's Toy Museum, a collection of Victorian toys. And paper toys as well. Looks like modern stuff too. Theatrical print warehouse. John Reddington carried on his business as a toy theatre maker and publisher from 1850 to 1876. His daughter married Benjamin Pollock, who took over the shop on Reddington's death. So, actual ancient stuff. This is Whitfield Street again. We passed it at the top. Used to have the first internet cafe here, Siberia. Somewhere down here, but it's long gone. That's Pollock's Toy Museum. medallion to go. Street tube station. I'm going to just cross over here if I can. Well, you see there, the reddish one, the Dianetics and Scientology shop. L. Ron Hubbard's first Scientology location, I think, was on Charlotte Street or Fitzroy Street, one of those two, somewhere. But they've come onto the main road here to brainwash more people. Now, strictly, we've come out of Fitzrovia. We're now in Bloomsbury, but I just wanted to see one little thing. In addition, a giant teddy bear. But this strange building, it's now a warehouse. Let me cross over, get a better view. It's a data warehouse, but it's called the Eisenhower Centre because this was General Eisenhower's headquarters in the UK during the Second World War. And it doesn't look like much now, but underground there are vast tunnels. They were actually building an extension or a parallel line to the Northern Line before the war, but it was abandoned when the war started. But the tunnels still exist. And in fact, during the war, they used it as a transit camp for up to 2,000 troops at a time. So there you go. Both ways, but Tottenham Court Road is one-way street. Oh, there are cyclists. Ah, interesting. Oh yes, two-way now. How strange. Let's head back into Fitzrovia. Not sure where I wanted to go here. There's lots of little alleys around here and I wanted to find some. I think it's down.
Honest to God.
Down Whitfield Street somewhere, possibly. Here we are. The movie poster art gallery. Have a little garden. See the residents keep it looking nice. This is called Colville Place. We'll come back to Charlotte Street in a minute, says the BT Tower again. On Gooch Street. Charlotte Place.
I didn't hear you call.
Another little lane. More commercial, this one. Gluten-free bakery. stations.
Get some breakfast.
The current Duke of York showing on the sign. So this is Rathbone Place, which is nothing much. As far as I know. Charlotte Street again. Mexico. We have there, across the road, the Fitzroy Tavern. If you can see it against the sunlight. I can't see what the camera's seeing because the light's too bright. But in there, people like George Orwell and Dylan Thomas used to drink, and indeed Aleister Crowley. Now the road ahead goes down to Oxford Street, the southern boundary of Fitzrovia. Somewhere around here, this is Percy Street. I think it was at number 4, the half-brother of a certain infamous German Chancellor used to live here and was visited by him in 1912, it's thought. Just around the corner from the Eisenhower Centre, ironically enough. I guess at the time of the visit, neither of them had any clue as to what was going to unfold. His half-brother was called Alois, I think, or something like that. Began with an A as well, anyway. I think we'll just wander down the last bit of Tottenham Court Road and finish off the video there. different art gallery. Vegetarian restaurant. California kitchen. Plenty of places to eat if you don't mind paying a little more than you'd like. The Jack Horner. Indian cinema.
Man, look at that. They've ruined it.
They've ruined it.
Warhammer shop. Might wander down a little side alley actually, because there used to be a games workshop shop down there. Now they've all gone over. It used to be Dungeons and Dragons, but they've gone over to Warhammer stuff now. Like for the last couple of decades at least. But I used to come down here once a month to get the latest issue of White Dwarf magazine. I think that grey building was a YMCA HQ. I don't know if it still is. I think this was the little alley. Hanway Street. might have been here or maybe the next one. Once upon a time. Street. That's it for today. See you in another video sometime. Okay, bye for now.